Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to thank Representatives Watson and Kortz and Hennessey for joining me in sponsoring this resolution, along with so many of you, our colleagues. And I'd like to thank our guests who've traveled to Harrisburg to be with us today. These individuals are doing very important work on behalf of our state. They are advocates who are working for a cure. They are caregivers who are helping a loved one through this devastating disease. And they are those who are living with Alzheimer's, whose determination to raise awareness and find a cure is a legacy we must honor. As many as 400,000 Pennsylvanians have been diagnosed with Alzheimer's or related disorders. When you factor in the 670,000 informal caregivers, that means more than 1 million Pennsylvanians are directly impacted by Alzheimer's. I'd like to introduce some of our guests who are to the left of the speaker. We have Sandy Waugh, a York native who's living with Alzheimer's. She's been an early stage advocate, sharing her story and bringing about awareness and hope for those living with Alzheimer's. I'd like to ask Sandy to rise, and I'll talk about the other folks as well. We have Jennifer Holcomb. She's from Hanover, and she's been involved in helping those touched by Alzheimer's over the last 2 years. She volunteers with the Alzheimer's Association, facilitating support groups for people who have been diagnosed and their partners. We have Craig Porterfield. Craig has been an administrator in long-term care for 14 years, where he has seen the devastating effect of this disease on residents and their families. He's an advocate, and he's also an Alzheimer's ambassador recognized by the National Alzheimer's Association. We have Lara Greenberg, who's the weekend anchor at CBS 21, and whose dad, Bruce, was diagnosed with younger onset Alzheimer's. Since that diagnosis, she has been a fierce advocate, helping to raise awareness. She won a regional Emmy Award in 2016 for stories featuring her father and the family and her family's experience. And also, we have Tom Brophy. He is one of those folks who has early onset Alzheimer's. He testified before the House Aging and Older Adult Services Committee back in June, telling us that until a cure is found, we must build awareness around the importance of early detection and support for caregivers. He's a member of the Delaware Valley Early Stage Advisory Council. He speaks at Alzheimer's Association events, and he advocates for public policy on the state and the federal level. We appreciate all of their efforts, and we're joined by other representatives of the Alzheimer's Association in the back of the house. Their work is so important because only about half of those who have Alzheimer's have been diagnosed, which means only about half of the caregivers know of their loved one's diagnosis. If a person is unaware they have the disease, they can't participate in care planning and making financial arrangements, and also focusing on spending precious moments with family and friends while they are still healthy enough to do so. When caregivers are unaware, they can't get the wheels in motion to arrange for services that will help them care for their loved one as the disease progresses. Resolutions like this one help promote awareness, but Pennsylvania is doing so much more. In 2014, we adopted the state plan for Alzheimer's disease and related disorders. This plan focuses on improving home and community-based services, promoting brain health to prevent Alzheimer's, and encouraging physicians to be proactive in diagnosing and informing patients and their families. Next month, the Department of Aging is hosting a forum on Alzheimer's and related disorders, where we will look at what next steps should be taken to supporting those who are diagnosed, their care partners, and their families. Our Alzheimer's associations are educating the public, they're helping families, and they're supporting research. And every year, thousands of Pennsylvanians participate in the Walk to End Alzheimer's, raising money to fight this disease and support all who are touched by it. Together, let's show our commitment to raise awareness. Let's honor those who've been diagnosed. Let's help all caregivers, and let's find a cure. I'd like to introduce Representative Kathy Watson.
Representative Watson, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you, Mr. Samuelson. Mr. Samuelson and Mr. Hennessey are chairman of the Aging and Older Adult Services Committee, and Mr. Kortz and I are good friends, and we have the Alzheimer's Caucus. Many of you are members because many of you have been touched in some way, a family member, a friend, a former teacher, whatever it might be, you've been touched by Alzheimer's or related dementia diseases. The purpose of this resolution, as eloquently stated by Mr. Samuelson, is to raise awareness. I think that Alzheimer's, while the statistics are terrible because it's the sixth leading cause of death in America, the only cause of death among the top 10 that cannot be prevented, it can't be cured, or even most of the time slowed down. But I also think it is a function of all of those of us, myself included, who have had the opportunity to live longer. And it's something that we are all afraid of. How many times have you said, because you forgot someone's name or you forgot something and you go, do you think this is it? Am I getting Alzheimer's? Dementia? Oh my gosh, I must be getting older. Ladies and gentlemen, we can't be afraid. We can't think that way. We need to be involved. We need to find that cure, to promote treatment that will stop Alzheimer's in its tracks. Maybe there will be early onset, but it won't go any further. The Alzheimer's Association, who is represented here today, is really the lifeline for those who are living with the disease and those family members and friends who help care for those who have the disease. They are a valuable resource. Mr. Samuelson took most of my speech, actually, because the facts are the facts. But if I can, and if you want to jot it down for your constituents or for someone in your family, I would ask you to jot down these numbers and the website. You can get all the facts you need to know about Alzheimer's disease and the help that is available now by going to www.alz.org/PA. They also have a 24/7 hotline and are able to help those who speak 200 different languages. So help is available for most of our constituents. That helpline, 1-800-272-3900. Anyone can call. As I said, it's 24/7. And indeed, for some caregivers, there might be a time when they call, and it is 11 o'clock at night. But there is help available. We do have a state plan. I worked on that, passed in 2014. That plan sets out a steep climb that we would have to do. But you know what? It's one step at a time, and we will get there. We ask for your support. We ask for you to tell others about awareness, about brain health, and about caring for people with this disease. We thank our caregivers because what they do is amazing. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Representative Bill Kortz is recognized. Sir, you may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank Chairman Samuelson and Chairman Hennessey and the co-chair of our Alzheimer's Caucus, Representative Watson, for bringing this resolution to the House floor. Mr. Speaker, as you've heard, this disease affects hundreds of thousands of people in Pennsylvania every year. We have a million or so folks that are currently affected, and millions upon millions upon millions more across the United States that have fallen afflicted to this disease. It is a deadly disease. It's a disease that knows no boundaries. This disease does not know gender, age, race, nationality. This disease doesn't know what walk of life you have. It didn't know that my mother, Dorothy Kortz, was a manager of a 300-unit housing association. It didn't know that the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, would be afflicted. This disease, Mr. Speaker, has no boundaries, no boundaries at all. Mr. Speaker, this disease severely affects the frontline caregivers, the families that are involved, the folks that are here today. All of us that have been involved, we know the pain. We know the pain that the frontline families have over this. In 2015, over 600,000 Pennsylvanians provided over 700 million hours of unpaid care, the frontline caregivers, worth an estimated $9.3 billion in care costs. And nationally, over 15 million Americans do the same thing. Mr. Speaker, hopefully someday a cure will be found for this terrible disease. But I want to thank all my colleagues today for supporting this resolution, and hopefully we'll get that cure soon. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to introduce Chairman Hennessey.
Chairman Tim Hennessey.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And colleagues, as chair of the House Aging and Older Adult Services Committee, I stand in support of House Resolution 1066, which designates November 2016 as Alzheimer's Disease Awareness Month. But it goes beyond that. It celebrates our family caregivers and all our informal caregivers around our Commonwealth. The members of the House Committee on Aging are committed to helping those caregivers and their loved ones in every way we can. I was honored to serve on the Alzheimer's Disease State Planning Committee, which was really the brainchild of Representative Watson. And although Pennsylvania has accomplished a great deal over the past few years, the plan showed that there's much more that we can do to assist our caregivers and residents suffering from Alzheimer's disease and related disorders. Now our challenge is to see the distinct goals and directions of that state plan put into action. To that end, we've met at the University of Pennsylvania on several occasions over the past year, and we've scheduled another Alzheimer's Summit for next month. As we consider this terrible disease and its ramifications, we need to take a moment to acknowledge the monumental efforts of family caregivers all across our Commonwealth. Many of them work full-time jobs, sometimes missing work to care for their loved ones. And some devote all their waking hours to caring for and assisting those in need. It can be stressful, it can be exhausting, and it can be expensive, but they do it out of love. So we thank all those caregivers for their dedication, their devotion, and for all of the sacrifices they make on a daily basis. As my colleagues have stated, the Alzheimer's Association has two wonderful chapters that cover Pennsylvania. They continue to be a wonderful resource for those living with ADRD and for their caregivers and their families. Again, the 24-hour, seven-day-a-week helpline is available 1-800-272-3900. Thank you very much for your interest, your concern, and hopefully your dedication to this cause as we find a cure for Alzheimer's disease. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.